Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and the December update for Google Pixel phones, as well as Essential Phone and some other phones, is now available. And you can install it either over the air on a Pixel 3, 3A XL, or any of the Pixel devices. However, there are a couple exceptions. For example, this is the last update that the original Pixel and Pixel XL will receive. It will no longer receive any updates. So this is the last update, so make sure you install this. It's got a bunch of security updates I'll talk about in a moment, but it's the last one for this device. Now, the other exception is, depending on when you're watching this, if you have a Pixel 4 or 4 XL, the update is not available yet, but it will be available next week or 1 week from when they released it, according to Google. So the update has a lot of fixes for the Pixel 4 and 4 XL, but it's not available yet. But the update is available for all the other Pixel devices. So let's go over what's new. And the first thing is the build number. And the build number can vary depending on device and region. So I'll just go over what we have here. We have QQ1A.191205.011. And that's on the 3A XL. Now, as far as the updates and things, one of the things that people have noticed is that the gesture navigation that I have here will now work with third-party launchers on older devices. So if you have a Pixel 2 or 2 XL or 3 or 3A or any of those, you should be able to use the gesture navigation with the actual launcher that you're using, not just the stock Pixel launcher. So if you've been wanting to do that, you should be able to do that. Now, there are specific fixes, and a lot of them will carry over to the Pixel 4 only, but let's go over them one by one. Now, on the Pixel 4, if you were having static when you were playing Spotify, that should now be resolved. So that will be fixed once it's available for the Pixel 4 and 4 XL. Also for the same device is there's a fix for background audio static in third-party camera apps. So if you're using a third-party app, you're not using the stock camera app for the Pixel, it should fix any of the static issues. Also, in the bootloader, dark mode is now supported on the Pixel 4 and 4 XL. So whatever the bootloader is on here when you're booting up, if it was just a white background, it will now be a dark background if you're using dark mode. And then on the Pixel 3, 3A, 3A XL, 4, and 4 XL, there's now a fix for Bluetooth pairing when it loses that information. So if you were having issues with Bluetooth just losing that information, that should now be resolved on the all those devices that I mentioned. Now, on the Pixel 4 and 4 XL, there will be a fix for pairing it with Garmin devices. So if you were having an issue pairing this with a Garmin watch or accessory, that should now be fixed as well. There's also a fix for the display on the 4 and 4 XL for screen flicker. So in various use cases, if you were having the screen flicker, I've seen a lot of people say they've had this, that should be resolved as well. They've also improved haptic vibration intensity in certain cases with the 4 and 4 XL. So maybe it wasn't working well or it wasn't consistent throughout. It will now work properly. They've also fixed misaligned device orientation in certain cases. So maybe it was rotated to the side in a certain app. That should be resolved as well. And if the device orientation was incorrect, it should be fixed on the 4 and 4 XL. Now, the final fix that they mentioned specifically carries from the Pixel 2 all the way to the Pixel 4 and all the devices in between, and that is a fix for the Google Pay card display in the power menu. So when you push power, if you have your Google card in here, it should fix that if it wasn't showing properly. I don't have it set up, but if you have it set up, it should work properly now. Those are the specific fixes that Google actually calls out in this update bulletin, but they also said, in addition to the specific items listed, the December update includes hundreds of various fixes and improvements across many areas, including performance, stability, camera, display, and face unlock. So maybe we'll get that face unlock improvement where you can't just have your eyes closed and still have it unlocked. Maybe that will be fixed. We'll only know that for sure in a week or so when the actual update is released for the 4 and 4 XL. Now, there are many security fixes. I'll link all that information in the description if you want to read it yourself, but there are moderate to high security updates. There are 7 framework fixes, 2 media framework fixes, 8 system fixes, 1 media codec fix, 3 kernel component fixes, 12 Qualcomm components, and then 10 Qualcomm closed source component security fixes. All of those security fixes are included in this December update. Now, as far as performance on these devices, even on the slower 3AXL, I haven't seen any performance issues. Everything seems to be nice and fast. If you want to go into the camera, it launches pretty reasonably. I really have not had any issues whatsoever as far as speed or anything working properly. Let's hit try again here. But everything seems to be super fast and smooth, and I really have no issues whatsoever with it. So I really like that Google tells us exactly what's in these updates and how often they're being released. Now, I highly recommend you install this update, especially if you have a Pixel or Pixel XL, since it's the last major update where you'll get all of these security fixes for this device. I definitely recommend installing it. But let me know what you think about this update in the comments below. Have you already installed it? Are you going to sideload it? Usually I have to sideload it in order to get it in time, but I just wanted to let you know all of the different features. And then next week, if we see anything new, I'll do a follow-up with it on the Pixel 4 or 4 XL. But let me know your thoughts in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.